Wow, that is a strong magnet. In case you didn't know, my name is Linus. Yep, HP sponsored today's video, and part of the requirements are that I need to introduce myself. So, hi. Now for the much less awkward part. HP's got a new 2-in-1 laptop tablet hybrid that looks absolutely fantastic if you've been looking to replace your at-home device with something a little more versatile. Short battery life got you down? Well, this could be the solution. We've got a power cable, power adapter with a nice sort of fabric style braided cable, and perhaps most importantly, a really interesting trick up the sleeve of the HP Elite Folio. Let's take a look at what makes it stand out from the crowd. We've been seeing more and more ARM-based Windows devices recently, and even more are on the way as the software support improves. And this guy here is no exception. Now, your configuration may vary depending on where you get yours from and what options you choose, but we've got a Qualcomm Snapdragon 8cx Gen 2 processor running between 1.8 and 3.15 gigahertz, 16 gigs of RAM, and a 256 gig NVMe SSD for rapid boot times. It's a bit dear, costing a little under $2,000, but like I said before, this video is sponsored by HP. So obviously we're gonna get to the part where we justify the cost later. First, gaming performance. Now, obviously this was designed more for video conferencing, making annotations to documents and designs. I mean, particularly the fact that it has built-in stylus with an actual place to freaking store it. I mean, how crazy does it make you when you see a product with a stylus and it's like, yeah, you're just gonna have to keep the stylus in the, I don't know, the backpack that you now also have to carry around with you instead of just having a convenient place to tuck it that's built right into the product magnetically. That's freaking awesome. It's great for browsing the web or getting work done at home or on the go, but you know, guys, we're Linus Tech Tips, so obviously we were gonna try to game on it. Rocket League? Yeah, that didn't launch at all. And that's gonna be the case with most hardcore games. But we did manage to get some lighter titles like Stardew Valley and Graveyard Keeper running. And I am going to try Graveyard Keeper right now. This is awesome. This is like actually working.
Yeah.
Go figure, right? On a mobile GPU effectively. I mean, obviously this is not like the world's most graphically intensive game or anything like that. But the story here is that like, it works, right? So when you're on a plane and you finally run out of like emails to reply to or whatever, you can go pick some peat moss. By the way, make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss out on our upcoming video about graphics options in games, because you don't have to worry about them here, but those max settings are, why do they even exist again? We're gonna get into that. Now, pivoting though to ideal workloads for the Elite Folio, it's a much more compelling story. One of our writers actually ended up taking one of our two units home to use for a couple of weeks, doing everything from browsing Reddit before bed in tablet mode, to using the pull forward design for displaying recipes in the kitchen, to holding scripts in the traditional laptop layout during a shoot and so that I can read off of it. I remember that. And everything in between. And it never got overly warm. The vegan leather is super soft to the touch. And get this, it's wipe resistant. Can we try that?
Yeah.
Oh, 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 this is awful. I'm sorry, everyone. Wow, that is a lot of ketchup. I guess what I would probably do if I was trying to clean something is first I'd get the, you know, the main goops off, right? So now it's, yeah, it's been wiped. I can't say I completely understand what that means. So I did actually get all the ketchup out of the trackpad, so that's good. And it resisted being wiped, I suppose. So if you gotta, you know, grab a snack, right? You're sitting at the coffee shop, you pour ketchup all over your laptop, unfortunately, you can wipe it. Okay, seriously though, back a little bit more on topic. ARM on Windows is not perfect yet, but given that most of our work here at Linus Media Group runs in either G Suite or Office 365, sorry editors, that's work too, but I'm talking more about like the writing team stuff. the compatibility issues that might affect someone like a video editor or a gamer, they don't really show up. The kind of thing you would notice would be the keyboard, and it actually feels great to type on. It's really quiet. I really like it. I mean, HP's been making great notebook laptops for a long time. Ah, 90. Okay, well, apparently that's it. I type 90 words per minute. Yeah, there's a bunch of points that the writer Plouffe put in here about how it's well laid out, even though this is a super compact device. And point is, while you're on a conference call, it's super quiet, really comfortable to type on, and manages to be like a soft bottom out, but without completely lacking a tactile feel. That's absolutely critical for a business machine like this, and definitely holds its own against similarly priced laptops. The chassis is magnesium and super thin. The trackpad feels good, smells like ketchup. Your mileage may vary on that one. And 2-in-1 hinge designs have clearly come a long way from when the first convertibles showed up. Like, I absolutely love the super strong magnetism of this hinge. It's never something that you're gonna feel like gonna accidentally turn floppy doodly over time. Remember when they called them convertibles? Like back when they first started marketing these things? 2-in-1 is definitely a better name for it. Just like that, like any 2-in-1, as soon as you flip it into tablet mode, it goes ahead and, you know, enables auto rotate and fancy stuff like that. For I/O, you've got a 3.5mm headphone jack and 2 USB Type-C ports, one on either side. That does mean you'll need a hub if you're using a wired mouse, for example, but thankfully there's no special ARM-compatible hubs or anything like that. You just use a normal one. And the Type-C ports are for charging as well. That is, when the battery eventually dies. It's rated for a whopping 25 hours of video playback on a single charge, which is 3 normal work days or 2 super long ones, which is absolutely perfect for when business travel becomes a thing again. On that note, it's also got a SIM card slot hidden away next to the stylus that we totally didn't talk about yet, but that'll allow you to stay connected just about anywhere via 4G LTE, 5G, or Wi-Fi 6. All of these features, battery life, cellular connectivity, and of course the fanless design trace back to the Qualcomm Snapdragon Compute chipset. And, oh right, this is where I was supposed to talk about the stylus, but I ended up talking about it earlier because it's so cool. I mean, you know, business, right? Sign documents or whatever. In terms of the speakers, they're made by HP, but tuned by Bang & Olufsen. I mean, obviously we're not expecting a ton of bass on a device this size, but I'd say given the size, Bang & Olufsen did a bang up job of tuning it. Yeah, that's like super respectable. It's not room filling by any stretch of the imagination, but I don't expect it to be, and what it does have is excellent clarity. I wouldn't say the webcam is the best I've ever seen, but I'll let you guys be the judge in terms of how you feel it looks. And since we're already talking about things that are not all sunshine and rainbows, I already mentioned the lack of legacy USB-A ports, but like other SoC-based notebooks, there is functionally zero upgradability, and it is a little on the heavy side, especially if you're using it as a tablet, at roughly 3 pounds. The flip side of that though, get it? Flip side of that, is at least it feels, you know, reassuringly hefty. Speaking of assurance, you can get an optional HP SureView Reflect screen to prevent unwanted helpers from glancing over at your screen, allowing you to work on whatever you want, wherever you want. We've actually tried that out before and it is super cool. And another feature that I talked about briefly but haven't actually shown you guys yet, it's becoming a staple on privacy-oriented devices, is a physical shutter for the included webcam. So you don't have to worry about someone getting access to your device and peeping on you. Unless you're an exhibitionist like that and you just don't care. So what do you guys think? Are we finally moving towards ARM on Windows now that truly AAA devices like this exist without Intel or AMD CPUs? Do you need a new tablet or laptop and can't decide what to get? Let us know in the comments and make sure to check out our latest build stream, by the way. It's called I Was Bored, So I Built a Computer. It was a lot of fun, as always.